Dealing with joint pain. Joint pain forms a regular part of life for most older men and women. Dealing with it can be a pain figuratively and literally. There are veritable barrages of information and help available for dealing with joint pain. Everything from commercials for medication to heated patches to herbs to acupuncture. Wading through the information can be overwhelming. The good news is, even without getting rid of joint pain completely, there are things you can do to help keep your joints limber while you look for the perfect solution for your joint pain. We'll look at some of them. The first thing, and probably the most important, is to keep moving. When your joints hurt, moving them can be agony. Humans naturally have a tendency to freeze up, to be as still as they can be, and to hope that the pain will just go away. Don't. Not moving is the worst thing you can do for joint pain. Moving hurts a little, especially at first, but as your joints start to limber up, it can keep them from getting even stiffer. And make everyday things like sitting down to eat or getting up in the morning actually possible. By not moving, you're sending a signal of surrender to the pain and it will move and take advantage of it faster than you can say acetaminophen. A low-stress yoga program, or some other daily exercise that keeps you limber, can come in handy here. The second thing to do is to keep warm. Cold joints are stiff joints, and stiff joints are painful. Staying warm won't get rid of joint pain completely, but, like keeping your joints limber, it will keep them from getting worse than they already are. If you feel cold, start moving. Sitting in front of a television will make you cold no matter how high you have the heat set. If you're physically able to climb stairs, the movement is good for your joints, and it warms you up better than almost anything else. Dress warmly when going out of doors. Keep the heat as high as you need it to be, but remember that just turning up a thermostat isn't going to warm you up if you're cold down in your bones. Is joint pain remedy a possibility? Joint pain remedy is pursued by all joint pain sufferers, acute and chronic. Acute pain remedy is easier to achieve because acute joint pains are actually short-termed. They don't last for more than 8 weeks or thereabouts. It's a chronic pain remedy that is really something. Common causes of joint pain are injuries in the joints, autoimmune disorders like rheumatoid arthritis, bursitis, septic arthritis, etc. Taking joint pain medication is a common way people try to achieve joint pain remedy. While this works for some without any problems, it doesn't work well for others as side effects are suffered. Surgery has proven to work well with some people. Some people experience pain remedy after undergoing surgery in the affected joints, but for some, the joint pain still persists, though in a milder form after surgery, only to spring up a full force at a later date when a strain or an injury occurs. But it is worthy of note that not all joint pains need surgery. It's the extent of the damage and the cause of the damage that determine whether surgery would be carried out or not. Though surgery is not for everyone, the use of supplements can be useful for every joint pain sufferers seeking pain remedy. Supplements like glucosamine sulfate and chondroitin have been found to be very effective in joint pain remedy. Glucosamine is a natural substance that keeps cartilage from fraying and can help you produce more cartilage. And chondroitin is a natural substance found in cartilage, which helps slow cartilage breakdown, thus allowing you to move with less pain. Studies have shown that glucosamine helps the body's repair mechanism with the promotion of the production of collagen. Collagen is a protein that actually holds connective tissue together. The use of alternative therapy and herbs are also gaining popularity in joint pain remedy. Some examples are huzhang, a Chinese herb that assists in the reversing of free radical damage to the joint, turmeric, grapeseed extract, ginger extract, etc. Joint pain remedy is a possibility, but it is advisable you let your physician assist you in the course of action you are to take, drugs, natural healing, surgery. The question is, will it be a permanent remedy or a temporal relief? Holistic healing for joint pain relief. Joint pain attacks every aspect of your life, from the time you get up until the time you lie down again, and everything in between. Simple activities like sitting down or kneeling become painful. Joint pain relief becomes something you desire on a daily basis. But medications for joint pain relief are often expensive, and they can have nasty side effects. As if that wasn't enough, they can also be strongly habit-forming, sometimes to the point of addiction. But in the face of daily pain, what other options are there? Are there any? Holistic healing says there are. Holistic healing has several alternative treatments for joint pain relief. It's important to remember when looking for alternative sources of treatment for joint pain relief that not every treatment will work for you. Unlike medication, which claims to be able to blanket treat joint pain no matter who you are, holistic healing is very much tailored towards treating individual pain in individual people. If one method doesn't work for you, I strongly encourage you to try a different method. Or, to some extent, mix and match different methods, for example, blending herbs and acupuncture. Creating a method of joint pain relief that works for you, as an individual, is a large part of holistic healing. But it tends to discourage some people, who, perhaps, expect herbs or creams to work like medicine. It doesn't. You have to find the method that's right for you, and that sometimes means trial and error. Various holistic methods of joint pain relief include herbs, see an herbalist or consult a reliable book. Most notably Jethro Kloss's Back to Eden, for a list of herbs that ease joint pain, and how to use them. Cremes, especially lard or Crisco, infused with red pepper capsicum, for pain relief due to arthritis, and acupuncture. One important thing to remember, certain herbal remedies can be dangerous when combined with modern medicine. Discuss any herbs you're taking with your doctor if you're also taking any kind of prescription medication of any kind, and also, discuss any medications you're taking with your herbalist. If you're concerned about the effects of medicines and herbs together, or if you can't find a reliable herbalist, try acupuncture or cremes, or herbal poultices rather than herbal infusions. Any of these can be safely used with other medicines. If you like this video, give this a thumbs up. Share this with your friends and don't forget to subscribe.